Hey guys, so sitting in here in my Honda here. Ever since I got this back window retinted, there's been a vibration happening when I play the music. I turn it up loud, whatever. And it's been bugging me the last like couple weeks or so. But I came back here to try to look at it because I drove it the other day going to pick up food, shopping and stuff. And it was vibrating. It was really bugging the crap out of me. So came in here and looking around, I had noticed that that plug was missing. That's basically just a fastener for this piece back here. But anyway, I got my little trusty fastener kit that I have. That's actually a very good deal off of Amazon. And I found me one that fits in there. Nice and tight, nice and snug. This other side here is still a little loose. I might replace that one. The other one on the end there seems good, but this other one here in the middle seems like it's a little loose. You can hear it. So I'm gonna see how this does. If this makes it better, I'm gonna pop out this one and replace it with a new one, and hopefully that'll get rid of the rattle that I got. If not, it's coming from somewhere else and I'm not exactly sure where, but I will figure that out and let you know. Later, guys. Okay guys, I don't know if you can see, but it is 3:46 a.m. October 12th. This is my security camera out in front of my house. It's about 74 degrees out and we're getting a freak snowstorm right now. That's like a complete blizzard going on out there right now. Happens every once in a while. Usually by morning the snow is all gone, but it is a freak snowstorm happening right now. Crazy, crazy weather. Alright guys, well it's another 80 degree, almost 90 degree day, 87 degrees. My lawn has been overgrown. I haven't edged it in like forever. So today I just ran the edger across it just to kind of break that grass up a little bit that's all growing over the thing. I couldn't find the edge of the sidewalk very easily, so I kind of ground down that blade that was on there. Now I do have a new one. Right here, which I'm going to be putting on here either later this afternoon or tomorrow. And then I'll cut the grass and then I'll go over the edging again. That's a good deep toothed blade, I think is what you call it. And it's long. It's the size it should be. This one I got on there now, it's several years old and it's ground down quite a bit, so it's not going as deep as it should. But I'm taking a break now because it's hot, 90 degrees. And I'm going to change that blade here, so I will show you that right now. Okay guys, this happens to be an electric edger, so you want to make sure that it's unplugged. And if you have a gas one, you want to make sure that you unplug the spark plug, just to be on the safe side, just to make sure nothing accidentally starts while you got your hands in there. So basically, first thing you want to do, get a piece of wood or something to put in here to keep this blade from turning when you remove this nut. This one happens to be a 14 millimeter nut. I'm just going to put a socket on there. You can use a socket, you can use a wrench, whatever you want. And there it goes. You take the nut off. Now there's going to be spacers. There's going to be one on the top, the blade, and then there's going to be one on the bottom. Now, with that being said, those are still good. You can see the difference in the size of the blade here, how much it's worn. My old one here is worn down. You can reuse those spacers. Some blades come with new spacers, some blades don't. I'm just going to use the new ones. Now, what you also need to find out is you need to find out which way your blade turns. Most of them turn counterclockwise. Okay, but there are some that turn clockwise, so you need to find out which way your blade turns. The easiest way to do it, start it up, hit the button, see which way it turns. Now, these blades have on them this side out, so you want to make sure that that's the side that you're looking at when you put it on. So, mine happens to go counterclockwise, so I need to put these teeth as it comes around clockwise to cut into the ground. So I'm going to take the spacer, the first spacer, put it on. I'm going to drop the blade in, take the second spacer, put it up on top. You take the nut, screw that back on, and basically all you do is you just tighten it up. Give it a good little nudge. Make sure that's on there nice and tight. Take that out. There you go. You got yourself a new edger blade. And that will put a nice deep groove again. Where this one, you can see the difference in size here. It's worn down quite a bit. I got a lot of room here now. If you look at where this hole is, I mean, that's a good inch I'm losing. So that's going to help give me a nice big deep edge again. And you just got to watch when it starts getting close up to those wear buttons, that's when you want to change it again. Pretty simple, pretty easy. Okay guys, if you could see that little groove right there, that was done with the old blade. Not very deep, kind of light. I'm going to do this same little section here with the new blade so you can see the difference. Guys, that's what the new blade does. Huge difference. So now I just got to go do the whole rest of my lawn, get it nice and clean again. Later guys. Hey guys, so I'm pretty sure that my lawnmower has a bad float valve and needle in it. I cut my grass yesterday, looks pretty good. Put my lawnmower in the garage, and there's still some gas in the tank, and I don't know if you can see that in there, but there is gas leaking out, coming from the carburetor there, and that's a sure tell sign that it is the float valve and the needle assembly. So I just need to get this to get me through possibly about another month and a half, and then I can... Then I won't have to cut the grass again until probably like February or March or something. But hopefully it'll get me through about another month or so. I think it will. Shouldn't be too bad. But do that, and then I can pull that apart and replace that float in the pin. So I will show you that when that happens, obviously. So that's about it. It's a nice day out here in Central Florida. Pretty close to 90 degrees again today, which I'm really getting tired of this heat. This heat this year has been ridiculous. It's been completely ridiculous. I usually like the heat. I like sitting out in the sun and everything, but this year I just couldn't do it. I just couldn't do it at all. So anyway, it's supposed to cool down come the weekend. Today is Wednesday, October 14th. And hopefully it's going to cool down, but then it says it's going right back up beginning of next week again. So hopefully only a couple more weeks in these high 80s here, and then it'll start cooling down, open the house up. So later, guys. Hey guys, show you my little boner stick, sticking up in the air. It's going to be a nice day. It's going to be 90 again today. But anyway, just wanted to tell you guys this. I heard that the Amazon building over here is starting to open up, the one that's right around the corner, the big warehouse there. So I heard there was a sign on there about it, so I drove by there. I just got back, drove by there. There's a sign on there Says, if you want to work here, I got to text Amazon to this number. So I'm going to be doing that the next couple days. Probably send a text out later this afternoon or tomorrow morning and see what that process involves and what it's all about. I have no idea. I really don't know. But I would really like to get in there and work because, I mean, I could walk there if I needed to. But anyway, just wanted to update you on that. Later, guys. Okay, guys, so I hope you liked the video. I'm looking at myself. I got corona hair going on here. It's just woke up a little while ago. It's 1:45, but I still woke up. Anyway, hope you liked that video. Not much going on, as usual lately. It's been really kind of dead and boring and everything around here. Not much to do or anything. But if you liked that video, appreciate it if you hit the thumbs up button. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. And if you would too, if you want to share this video, I know this one's kind of boring, but like some of my other ones, if you go back and watch some of my other ones, if you really like them or whatever, it would be cool if you would share them to, you know, maybe your social media pages so people can come and subscribe to my channel. That'd be awesome. But anyway, that's about it for now. Not much going on, like I said, so everybody stay safe. Oh, and by the way, I got to tell you, I did text Amazon, and currently they are not hiring at this location here. A guy signed up to get alerts and everything. I think what they're doing right now is they're bringing people in from other warehouses to get the things set up. Because when I drove by there, there were some cars in the parking lot, but there really wasn't that many. So I don't think it's fully open yet. I think they're still in the process of setting it up to get everything set up so that they can do like a mass hiring thing in a little while. I heard that they weren't fully going to open until the beginning of next year. So that's still several months away. So I think they're still setting it up. And that's why there's no jobs available there. But I'm staying on it. I'm going to keep on it because I'd really like to get in there. Like I said, it's literally right around the corner from my house. So anyway, guys, if you could like this video, the little thumbs up thing, and then subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, that would be awesome. And you guys stay safe, and I will talk to you later. Later, guys. Okay, guys, I don't know what's going on here, but and there was this envelope with my name on it sitting by my front door. Okay, I'm a little nervous right now, guys. It's a whole bunch of $100 bills. I'm shaking. I just called the police. They're on their way.